My image of waste is a dirty, great big mountain of rubbish surmounted by tipped turkeys and seagulls, taking up a huge expanse of land. And the smell, well, don't get me started on the smell. But fortunately, there's a new way of getting rid of waste. I've come to the town of Bassendean in Perth to chat to Mayor Renee McLennan to learn about their new three-bin system, FOGO. Renee, what is it all about?
So Bassendean's recently introduced FOGO collection. So FOGO is food organics and garden organics. We're one of the early adopters, so one of the first to introduce FOGO into our waste services. So food organics is basically all of your kitchen scraps, so your potato, vegetable and fruit peelings, any leftover meals and spoilt food. Your garden organics is your green waste, so things like branches, leaves, grass clippings, but it also includes other things like soiled cardboard and paper products, pet droppings, even kitty litter. So it's basically all of the stinky stuff that you'd normally put in your general waste bin now goes into your FOGO bin, with the exception of disposable nappies.
So what does this mean in the home?
So we wanted to make it as easy as possible for people to make the transition to the new system. So we've given every household a kitchen caddy and compostable caddy liners. So the idea is that people can have the caddy in their kitchen, and as they're preparing their meals, they can just pop the food scraps in. When the caddy is full, they can take that FOGO material out to their bin in the caddy liner and put it in the big 240 litre bin. The most important thing though is that people are aware of which waste goes in which of the three bins. So sorting it correctly at home is really important. We really want to keep plastic bags out of the FOGO material, so people need to put it into the compostable liners or into paper. We really don't want plastic or glass in particular ending up in the compost that is then on our sporting fields and the places where our children are playing. Before we introduced FOGO, more than half the contents of our general waste bins was organic matter. So that equates to around 200 kilos per person per year. And of course, all that was going straight to landfill. And we know in landfill that that organic matter breaks down and it produces methane, which is a really harmful greenhouse gas. It's about 28 times more potent than carbon dioxide. It also produces acidic material that can contaminate our groundwater. So it has a really negative impact on our environment and ultimately on our people.
How is this processed?
So once the FOGO material is emptied from our household bins, it's taken in trucks up to the Redhill Waste Facility, where we've got some modern composting technology. So basically a lot of oxygen is added, the material's aerated, and it starts to break down and is turned into compost. So it's a really good example of a circular economy where we're taking waste from the home, turning it into something useful, and then bringing it back to our community to use on our gardens. So we know our soils here are really depleted from nutrients, so the compost is going to come back to our community and people can use it on their own gardens, maybe for their veggie beds or as a foundation for their lawn. We can also use it on our parks and our sporting reserves, but there's also an opportunity for farmers, for vigneron and others to use this compost material to help enrich their soils and produce more.
It's ironic that the grey so-called Bassendean sands that exist right throughout the coastal plain of Perth are classified by the United Nations as the least fertile soils on the planet. I congratulate the town of Bassendean on their efforts to turn FOGO into beautiful, life-giving compost to make this soil something you can really grow plants in.